Hello everyone, today we are going to study gametogenesis. In the previous class you have learned the male and female reproductive system, and today we'll learn how the gametes are formed. Okay, when we talk about gamete or the gametogenesis, there are two gametes, as you know. One is male gamete and the another is female gamete. Okay, the male gamete is sperm and the female gamete is ovum, or it is also called as egg. So today we will study about the formation, the male gamete formation, that is sperm. So under gametogenesis we are going to study the formation of sperm, that is called as spermatogenesis. So now you got an idea where this spermatogenesis process takes place. Obviously in the male reproductive system, that too in the testis. Why we call the testis as primary sex organ, we have discussed already. So in the testis, that is in the male reproductive organ, in the testes, which are present in the scrotal sac, in each testes there are compartments, and each compartments are having 1 to 3 seminiferous tubule. So in the seminiferous tubule, the spermatogenesis process takes place. So the location of spermatogenesis is seminiferous tubule. Now we'll study spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis is the process of formation of sperm in the seminiferous tubule. The whole process is called as spermatogenesis. So the spermatogenesis is studied in 3 phases. This is the first phase, this is the second phase, and this is the third phase. This whole process, we study the whole process in 3 phases. The first phase is multiplication phase. Okay, in the multiplication phase, this is the germinal epithelium of seminiferous tubule, and this is a germ cell. In this first stage, a germ cell is going to divide into 2 cells, and when these 2 cells divide, it forms 4 cells. The same way, simply what we can say, what happens in multiplication phase means simply the number of cells gone increasing. Okay, so this germ cell, which is going to divide and redivide to produce so many cells, and those cells are called as spermatogonia. Spermatogonia are the cells which are produced by the division of germ cell. Simply we can say the germ cell, when it divides and redivides, and the division is mitosis. I hope you know what is mitosis and meiosis division, because already you have studied. But I'll just brief it. The mitosis division means where the mother cell, which is going to divide or split into 2 cells, both the daughter cells are having the same chromosome number as that of a mother cell. So mitosis, if it is deployed, if the mother cell is deployed, after mitosis whatever the chromosome number are present in the daughter cells, they are also deployed. So this is about mitosis. The first step is multiplication phase. In multiplication phase, what happens, after so many mitosis divisions, the germ cell is going to give rise to a number of cells, and these cells are called as spermatogonia. Okay, and it is diploid. What is mean by diploid? It is having 2 set of chromosomes. Now In the second stage or in the second phase, this is first, this is the second phase, which is called as growth phase. Okay, growth phase. In the growth phase, what happens? Already what we have? Spermatogonia. This spermatogonia is going to increase in the size. Okay, increase in size. This spermatogonia increase in the size because of the accumulation of nutrition, which is secreted by the germinal epithelium, obviously. So the reason of this growth is accumulation of the nutrition, and the spermatogonia increase itself. The size of the spermatogonia increases because of the accumulation of nutrition, and this particular cell is called as primary spermatocyte. And even this is 2N, you can observe the spermatogonia is diploid. 2N means diploid. And even this primary spermatocyte is also diploid. Now this primary spermatocyte is going to divide that too meiotically. Okay, so here the division was mitosis and here the division is meiosis or meiotic cell division. In meiotic cell division, what happens? The diploid cell is going to be haploid. Haploid means single set of chromosomes. Diploid means double set of chromosomes, that is two set of chromosomes. Now the primary spermatocyte is going to undergo meiotic cell division. So obviously when it undergoes meiotic cell division, the diploid cell is going to be haploid. Okay, N represents haploid. Now we got the secondary spermatocyte. Okay, so from here, this is the third phase. This third phase is called as maturation. Maturation phase. In the maturation phase, what happens? Simply, the primary spermatocyte which undergo meiotic division, this is the first meiotic division. In the meiotic division, the primary spermatocyte forms secondary spermatocyte. Secondary spermatocyte. Now again, this secondary spermatocytes are going to divide, and this is called second meiotic division. But here the division is not reductional division. Reductional division means this 2N to N. The first meiotic division is reductional division, where the diploid cell is going to convert itself into haploid. But in case of M2, that is meiotic 2, here the secondary spermatocytes are going to divide, but it is the equational division. Equational division. Equational division means again the haploid will remain as haploid only. It is not going to reduce. The number of chromosomes are not reduced here. The number of chromosome is maintained the same. That is why it is equational division. Remember, this meiotic 2, this second division of secondary spermatocyte is not reductional division. It is a equational division. From primary to secondary, it is reductional division, where the 2N is reduced to N. But in the second division, that is secondary spermatocyte divides, but it is a equational division. So now we got these cells which are also haploid, and these are called as spermatid. Spermatid. These are non-motile spherical cells. Now the spermatid is going to transform into sperm, where you can see the visible difference between the spermatid and the sperm. Sperm is the male gamete, or it is also called as spermatozoa. Zoa means moving. Okay, they are having a tail like structure and they can move. What is the difference between spermatid and sperm? It is that the spermatid is not having any tail like structure and it is spherical, but here the sperm is motile structure. And this spermatid, the transformation of a spermatid to sperm is called as spermiogenesis. Okay, spermiogenesis. Remember the meaning of spermiogenesis and spermatogenesis. Okay, you should not get confused between spermatogenesis and spermiogenesis. The difference is spermatogenesis means the whole process. Okay, the whole process of formation of the sperm from the germ cell. And spermiogenesis means the transformation of spermatid, non-motile spermatid, to a motile sperm. And this process, only this step, the last step, is called as spermiogenesis. One more word is there, that is spermiation. Spermiation. Okay, this is the next, this is next to spermatogenesis. So you know, just imagine the seminiferous tubule where the Sertoli cells are there. I told you when I was explaining about testes, this Sertoli cells are the nourishing cells which nourishes the formed or immature spermatid or sperm. Now the sperms which are formed here, I have written the whole process. The sperms which are formed here are immature. They embed their head in the Sertoli cell for their nourishment. Okay, once it is nourished and it is fully matured, then the mature sperm is released in the lumen. If it is a tubule, then there are Sertoli cells here and there where the immature sperms or the spermatozoa are getting nourishment. And once the spermatozoa is completely nourished and it is fully matured, then this release of this sperm, the completely mature sperm, into the lumen, okay, from here to here. This process is called as spermiation. Spermiation is nothing but the release of matured sperm from the Sertoli cells to the lumen of the seminiferous tubule. This process is called as spermiation. So, spermiation, spermiogenesis and spermatogenesis. These three definitions are also important. Here we complete the process of spermatogenesis, that is under gametogenesis. We'll study the structure of sperm, and this diagram is very important for 5 marks. Now, structure of sperm. The sperm is divided into, or the parts of the sperm is divided into 4 regions. One is the head region. This is the head region and it is the groove like structure. This is neck and this is called middle piece from here to here, and then the middle piece is going to narrow itself to form a tail. Okay, these are the 4 parts of sperm. Now in the head region you can see the green colored structure, it is called as acrosome. Okay, this acrosome is having some lysine enzyme for the breakdown of the layers of ovum. When the egg is going to be fertilized with the sperm during fertilization process, when the sperm comes, the layers of egg is dissolved by the enzymes which are present in the acrosome. Now it is a pointed nucleus which is containing the chromosomal material. Okay, the nucleus is filled with chromosomal material, and of course it is a haploid nucleus. Always remember, the gametes are haploid because they are having only one set of chromosomes, whether it is egg or sperm. It is a haploid nucleus which contains the chromosomal material. And next part is, in this axis the mitochondria is spirally placed to reduce the space. This is mitochondria. Okay, the mitochondria is spirally placed in this axis, and the mitochondria supplies the energy for the movement of the sperm. When the sperm is moving, the energy which is required is supplied by mitochondria. As you know that mitochondria is a powerhouse. Now this tail which is helpful in the movement of the sperm. Here we complete the structure of sperm. Now you may ask that how a spermatid transform itself into a sperm. Okay, it is a motile structure, it is non-motile structure. During the transformation, the first is condensation of nucleus. Okay, the nucleus which is present here in the spermatid is going to condense. By losing, it loses the RNA and some acidic proteins. Okay, acidic proteins. Only what is remained in the nucleus? Only DNA and some basic proteins are remained. Next is, the cytoplasm is reduced. The cytoplasm present in the spermatid is reduced. Only here a little in the tail region, little cytoplasm is remained, and in the rest of the part there is very reduced cytoplasm. Next, reduced cytoplasm. Next is the Golgi body. The Golgi body split itself into a larger pointed structure called as acrosome, where the accumulation of lysine enzymes, some enzymes which are required for the dissolving of the egg layers or membrane, egg membrane. Now, the next is, the nucleus which was spherical, it is pointed here. The nucleus is pointed. So this is the visible difference between the sperm and spermatid. The process of transformation of spermatid into sperm is called as, in the previous class we discussed, spermiogenesis. In spermiogenesis process, this spermatid undergo so many changes to form a sperm. Here we have studied the structure of sperm and its parts and the importance of acrosome, mitochondria and all other parts. In the next class, we'll discuss about oogenesis.